numbers should be analyzed on those things, and he has been successful in this. And last point I would like to tell you is, in a democracy, ultimately, public opinion is important. We are a political party. Winning of election is an important. अगर हम कुछ isolation में कहीं economic theory लिख रहे हो, कोई किताबों में university में पढ़ा रहे हो, वो बात अलग है. If we are into democracy, we have to win election. Every test of our policy will be elections. And where the public has accepted it, that means larger public is on support of that. That's also very important.
Beautiful points. And now I'd like to ask Prashant Ji's opinion on the three points which you have made. First point which you have made is, political change is not linear. It is messy. It may have humiliating reversals also. It can have long-term consequences. So wait before you come to your final verdict on this. The second point he has made is, equality doesn't only mean equality in rights or equality before the law, but equality in our circumstances. And today there is an ideology of equality, but a lot of material inequality really in the world. So do you feel that this government has delivered on making the material inequality a little less? And the third point he has said is, if we do not win elections, we will not be able to make the change which we wish to. So winning elections is very important. Do you agree with this? Or you have another alternative view on this? All these three points, Prashant Ji.
So let me start with the third point. He says that winning elections is important, and therefore, all right, equally important, and therefore one has to modulate one's policies to see that this will also help you win the elections. I'll give you one example of this. Kejriwal went to Punjab just before the Punjab elections. And he was asked by the reporters at that time, the Satluj-Yamuna link had become a big issue between Punjab and Haryana-Punjab, despite Supreme Court judgment saying that that link has to be made, these waters have to be brought from Punjab to Haryana. In Punjab, it was made a big electoral issue by virtually all the political parties. All the political parties, they were saying, no, we will not allow this canal to be made. They started blocking this canal. It had been almost completed. And no water of Punjab will go to Haryana. Now, Kejriwal had gone to Punjab for just before the elections, and he was asked by the reporters, what is your stand on this? One of the people who were there, who was also supposed to be one of the candidates of Aam Aadmi Party, one of the senior members of Punjab, he said that, sir, maine isme bahut study kiya hua. I was a former IAS officer. Aur maine is par ek 15 page ki ek report likhi hai. Aap usko padh lijiye, uske baad is par jawab dijiyega. He said, किंगड़ा जी, इस पर हमको कोई थीसिस थोड़ी लिखनी है, इस पर तो हमको राजनीति करनी है. एंड ही केम आउट एंड ही सेड कि नहीं, नो, नॉट वन ड्रॉप ऑफ वाटर विल गो फ्रॉम पंजाब टू हरियाणा. ही केम बैक टू दिल्ली एंड द हरियाणा चीफ मिनिस्टर सेड दैट, वेल, मिस्टर केजरीवाल हैज सेड नो ड्रॉप ऑफ वाटर विल बी अलाउड टू गो फ्रॉम पंजाब टू हरियाणा. In that case, not one drop of water will go from Haryana to Delhi. Reporters asked him, ab boliye aapko kya kehna hai? He said, nahi nahi, pani par rajniti nahi honi chahiye. Now the question is, ki agar if you are going to modulate your policies on electoral considerations in different states may be different wherever elections are taking place. And if there is an interstate issue, then clearly the electoral considerations will be different, and you will not be able to formulate a policy in public interest, in larger public interest, if you look at electoral considerations. So the question is, if a politician makes it his primary goal, ki look, I will say and do things which further my electoral interest or my party's electoral interest, then he will never become a statesman. He will always remain a petty, crass politician. That's not what we expect our elder politicians to be. We expect them to be statesmen. On the issue of inequality, economic inequality, I mean, I'm surprised that Mr. Aggarwal is saying that the present government has brought in policies or done things which have reduced economic inequality in this country. Every report, every data, every fact, every statistics, I can challenge Mr. Aggarwal ki I can take him through any number 100 which will show that income inequality in this country has increased in the last 3 years. That on the human development index, India has fallen below what it was 3 years ago. The poor, while farmers are not being able to get loans or get their loans written off, it is these big people like Adanis, Ambanis, and SR, etc., who are being able to get their loans written off from banks and etc., from public sector banks. On the issue of corruption, he said that structural reforms have to be brought to deal with corruption. The biggest structural reform was the Lokpal law to deal with corruption. Lokpal, that law came 4 years ago. For the last 4 years, Lokpal has not been appointed. Despite the Supreme Court, we went to the Supreme Court. Supreme Court ordered the government to appoint a Lokpal. It's been more than 6 months since that Supreme Court judgment. We are having to file a contempt petition against the government because of that. Lokpal has still not been appointed. Second major structural reform was the whistleblower law, which was to encourage whistleblowers who were working within the government to come and blow the whistle, and they were to be protected administratively as well as physically. That whistleblower law was passed, gazetted 4 years ago, again that it has not been notified till today. And now an amendment has been brought which says, whose only object is to destroy the entire law by saying that if a whistleblower provides any more information than what an ordinary citizen can obtain under the Right to Information Act, then he will not be regarded as a whistleblower, he will be prosecuted under the Official Secrets Act. This amendment has already been passed in the Lok Sabha, it is pending consideration in the Rajya Sabha, but the whole object of this amendment is to destroy the whistleblower law. The Central Vigilance Commission has been completely destroyed by appointing two corrupt people in the Central Vigilance Commission, one of whom is a person against whom the Central Vigilance Commission itself had said that he has fabricated the ACR of his junior officer while functioning as the chairman of a bank. The other officer is the person who had himself withheld the Birla Sahara diaries, did not send them to the CBI, even after the diaries disclosed payments of monies to a large number of politicians, etc. These persons have been brought and placed at the helm of affairs of the Central Vigilance Commission, which is supposed to be the second most important anti-corruption agency. The CBI is being attempted to be destroyed. Just recently, they have appointed an officer from Gujarat as the special director of the CBI, despite the fact that the director CBI had given a two-page note saying that this man is being investigated and is likely to be prosecuted in the Sterling Biotech case, and therefore he should not even be in the CBI, what to say of his promotion. And still he has been promoted on a Sunday by the ACC without even the file being sent to the Home Minister. The Prime Minister himself has signed the file and promoted this man on a Sunday when he was in Gujarat on an election tour. And we are saying that this government is tackling corruption? I mean, it's an absolute farce that we are seeing.
Okay, so very well made points and very passionately made. Just one point before I pass it on to Gopalji. It is found that first of all, and it is said also, that first you have to be a successful politician and then you can be a successful statesman. And this has been found. You see, Abraham Lincoln, he never opposed the prevailing opinion of the whites on racism till he reached the top position, and then he delivered the famous Gettysburg Address, say, declaring all men as equal. So sometimes leaders have been found to go with the prevailing taste in the hope of finding a position tomorrow where you can enact what you wish and then do so. So this is one point which I would like to ask you. Is it possible? Now I would like to ask, before that, I'd like to ask Gopalji, the points which Prashantji is saying is, first of all, on the honesty bit, the transparency, he's contesting if the government has really been transparent. What is your view on that? And he's also saying that whether equality has actually decreased or increased. These are the two points which he's making. What is your view on this?
One second. Just one, I just want to, before he answers, one more thing. See, talking about transparency, the Central Information Commission passed an order saying that political parties must